We have to start by Manchester City and Jack Grealish. Oggy, you will give us the latest of what we have on that, but is it a good idea for you? Is it a good thing to spend all that money on Jack Grealish if you're City?
I can see why they'd want a player like that, because they're a passing team, really, Manchester City. And we saw in the Champions League final that if the team is set up against them and defend really well, it's sometimes difficult to break teams down. Usually their passing and their movement is good enough. So you need somebody that can open up defences by taking somebody on. Manchester United had just bought Sancho. Grealish is probably even better at going past people. In a different way, he's a trickier rather than pacey. And I think he gives them another option. You know, if they need to break down defences, he can just wriggle away from a challenge and just change the setup of the defensive organisation of the opposition. And that's why I think he's going to be bought.
I agree with you.
Just to give them something different.
Yeah. Oggy, we're recording the show on Monday. Is this going to happen before some of our listeners and viewers see the show?
No, I don't think so. I don't think it'll be done in the next 24, 48 hours. I think it will take a few days. I think it could it be done for the Community Shield, possibly. I mean, deals never seem to happen very quickly these days, but I think this deal is much more likely to happen quickly, if at all, than Harry Kane to Man City. I think obviously there's an appetite with City and with Grealish for it to be done. I think we've seen that Villa have already signed Buendia from Norwich as a replacement. So, you know, Villa might play the game publicly to resist City's interest. But I do think that this deal will happen fairly quickly. It'd be good if it does happen before the Community Shield, so we can see him, you know, maybe play against Leicester at the weekend. But yeah, I do think Grealish comes in. I'm not sure he makes that much of a difference to Man City, because I think we've got so much attacking talent, so many attacking midfielders, you know, Raheem Sterling, Bernardo Silva, Riyad Mahrez, you know, Phil Foden. It's hard to see where they all fit in. So, yeah, Grealish makes them different, but I'm not sure. Is it £100 million with the difference? I'm not sure. I'm really not. It's a strange one for me.
And yeah, and you'll have to let some go. I mean, Raheem Sterling, still no negotiation of a new contract. You're not going to sell Phil Foden. Riyad Mahrez, maybe, who's hit 30, who turned 30 a few months ago.
But I think Mahrez has been a key player for them.
Yeah,
he's been very good, that ball they hit out to the right-hand side. Completely. And he comes in on his left foot. I think he's caused a lot of problems over the last season. He was at his best last season, so it seems a strange time to actually get rid of him when he's playing at his best. But Guardiola seems to have little spells of liking players and not liking players. Bernardo Silva was their best player a couple of years ago, and then suddenly he couldn't get into the side. You know, Sterling was the key player. Then, at the end of last season, he didn't play very often. So Pep Guardiola seems to have a little spells of liking players and disliking players. How Grealish fits in, we'll have to wait and see.
So no signing yet for City, but maybe, as we said, Grealish coming in. For Liverpool, only one signing so far is Ibrahima Konate, the young French centre-back. I don't know if you saw his shirt number revealed, the way he did it. He went back to his neighbourhood in Paris and had all his mates, and he was in the pitch where he used to play as a kid, and they had like fireworks, and he showed the number, which I thought was super cool, but obviously I'm biased. Oggy, are you disappointed that it's only Konate so far? Is it because there's not enough money there to go and sign a midfield replacement for Wijnaldum, who left on a free to go to PSG, for example? Is it because they're waiting to get the right target, or what's going on?
Yeah, I think they did well to get Konate so early. I think, you know, that shows Liverpool's, you know, dealing in the transfer market. But you look at Liverpool at the end of last season, I didn't really see them doing much anyway, because, you know, the front three isn't going to change very often, plus Diogo Jota, so they're not short there. In midfield, yeah, you could say that they need to replace Wijnaldum, but Henderson's fit again. Although Henderson's kind of not happy that he's not been given a new contract. They probably do need a younger player in midfield, but I don't quite know where to go. I mean, people talked about Tielemans at Leicester. I'm not sure Liverpool have got the money to do that right now. But, you know, the squad itself, I think there's definitely another good season in that squad. I think beyond that, you look at the age of the team and the key players, they're all late 20s, early 30s. They need to start looking long-term. But I think right now, in the middle of a pandemic where they've had financial issues, I think this is probably the best it's going to be for Liverpool.
Chelsea also have been quite quiet, considering what we thought they could do the summer that they had last year, where they spent so much money. The money is clearly still available. Are you surprised that they've been talking to players like Jules Koundé, for example, the Sevilla centre-back, and I think they will bring him eventually? They've had a lot of talks with Holland and bring him a striker, Lukaku as well. Where do you think Chelsea should strengthen, and are you surprised they haven't strengthened yet?
I think the two players that you're talking about, centre-forward, I still think they would need an out-and-out centre-forward. I don't think Timo Werner has been quite good enough.
Yeah.
And they often play him out on the left-hand side, coming in onto his right foot. The centre-halves, he looks like he's going to play with three at the back. Koundé would be the ideal centre-half on the right-hand side.
Yeah, definitely.
Azpilicueta has done it. Reece James has done it. Reece James did it very well, and Azpilicueta played at right wing-back. They've changed that around. But Koundé would come in and be absolutely ideal. He's quick, he can read danger, he's decent in the air, you know, for not a particularly big player. So I think it would be an ideal signing. So that would be the one that I would go with.
What about Arsenal? Ben White, £50 million. Are you...
It's a massive signing. We saw, and we're going to talk about it later, but we saw Arsenal play against Chelsea and still looked poor defensively, still made mistakes. Arsenal need Ben White to be the kingpin of that defence. If you're going to spend £50 million on a player, come in at centre-half, I know he's young, but he's almost got to be given... It's no good Arteta saying, well, we'll break him in gently and he's got to come in and be their leader. Yeah. He's got to be the one that reads the game. He's got to get others around him. He's got to go and be the one that comes out with the ball. He's got to be the Harry Maguire of Arsenal. He's got to go and lead from the front, right from the off.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.